some fucking noise!
Listen to Spreading the Virus 124 on Infestation. I'm Bacteria, and you are together for 1 hour listening to Poor Violence and a lot of grind tonight and minds goes, I don't know, I'm in a grind mood, so stay tuned and enjoy. Thanks for listening.
Fuck you, fuck you, fuck you, you're cool, and fuck you, I'm out.
Still sparing feelings because I hate all of this.
Jangan deh, jangan deket-deket putau, sabu, kokain, heroin, apa segala macam pil, obat, segala ekstasi, jangan deh, jangan. Tapi kalau lo emang suntuk, lo frustrasi, lo apa, yang alami aja deh, lo tahu sendiri kan.
This is not in the law!
I'm gonna get to the bottom of this, and I don't give a fuck if you're at the top.
Thank you. We'll be right back. сила границ. Мы не знаем, что делать с людьми в Ираке. Нам не нужно других групп. Нам нужно церковь.
Nothing would survive, not even bacteria.
Thank you. The infected mass is filled with fluid, pus and dead tissue. Fluid may drain out of the carbuncle, but sometimes the mass is so deep that it cannot drain on its own. Carbuncles may develop anywhere, but they are most common on the back and the nape of the neck. The carbuncle may be the size of a pea or as large as a golf ball. It may be red and irritated, and might hurt when touched.
hamburger was in a movie.
Summer vacation or standing ovation. I need clarification, no hesitation. So I did an investigation, and what I found all across this nation that eliminates most agitation is within this presentation.
Yo, baby, I have 7 CDs and 3 jam boxes.
$6 million to die. Choose one. Oh my gosh! Stop!
We'll be right back. The body is now falling apart, the tissues are falling apart. So you have external bacteria coming in to start breaking down the tissues further. These external factors are actually called the putrefaction.
Yeah. know, depression is really overwhelming, and sometimes even thinking of one thing to do to make yourself feel positive and happy is challenging. So...
$37 million, 37 million people, 14.5% of the nation's low poverty levels. Of that number, 29% were African Americans. 80 over 10 cities were poverty. Both women were public rat fights, tried and found between themselves and outside. Ever more draconian measures, to restrict, redress, restrain, and eliminate. It's reminded by observation of French writer Anatole France, the law, in its majestic equality, forbids the rich and all the poor to sleep in the bridges, to beg in the streets, to steal bread. Already, U.S. manufacturers have fled to NAFTA-friendly Mexico, and only the Zapatista insurgency in Chiapas has slowed an emerging flood of Western capital. Outgunned by the industrial wars by Japan and Germany, the U.S. has embarked on a low-technology, low-skill, high-employment scheme that exploits the poor, stupid, and the slow via a booming prison construction America's sole industry. Increasingly, more and more Americans are guarding more and more American prisoners. Major political party has an answer to this social dilemma, short of cages, graves. The time is ripe for a new, brighter, life-affirming vision that liberates, not represses, the poor. After all, are the vast majority of this group's people. Neither serpentine politics nor a sterile economic theory, which treats 1990 as mere economic news, offer much hope. The very politicians they vote for spit in their faces, while economists write them all as non-personal. It must come from the poor, a rebellion of the spirit that reaffirms their intrinsic human worth based upon who they are and what they possess. This is Mr. Abramov, your author.
Thanks for your hostility.